Hi everyone, I am Paula Olaya and I am a student at the University of Tennessee, Knoxville. And today I'm going to talk about the benefits of the convergence between high performance and cloud computing for composing an earth science workflow. This is a collaboration with Sandia National Lab, the University of Delaware, and IBM. The earth science workflow that we're referring to is SOMOS-5, which is a modular workflow that models and predicts fine-grained soil moisture values from coarse-grain satellite data. This workflow has multiple stages, starting from a data collection, which has multiple data sources, going through a feature extraction, and then a machine learning modeling where we get our soil moisture predictions that then are visualized and analyzed to a specific with a specific set of tools. We selected Oklahoma as a region of interest because it is a rich agricultural area, and we show how we go from a coarse satellite data with a resolution of 27 kilometers to a fine-grained soil moisture prediction with a resolution of 90 meters using SOMOS-5. Depending on the resolution, we get a specific size of data. So for our previous example, 90 meters, our data size is around 5 gigabytes. When we go to a finer resolution like 10 meters, our data increases to 420 gigabytes of data. As we go to a finer resolution, such as 1 meter, this data increases, reaching 42 terabytes of data. And this is only for Oklahoma. So now let's imagine how would it be for the whole United States of America or the whole world. Identifying that data is such a key component in the SOMOS-5 workflow, we know that we require a scalable and elastic tool for supporting and storing this data and allowing us to deploy the workflow. With this in mind, we selected the object storage as our solution. An object storage stores the data as objects, and there is no file hierarchy, therefore it enables infinite scalability, which is specifically what we need for our SOMOS-5 workflow. When we first worked with it, we were not caching, and the throughput that we were obtaining was around 10.2 megabytes per second. So we explored different ways through caching to improve this throughput. The first one is caching in the boot volume of the worker node, then caching in the RAM, and finally caching in the storage node. Each of these have different settings, but what I want you to focus on is that for all of them, the throughput was improved. We selected the first option, given that it was the highest improvement in throughput. Once we know that our data is in the cloud, we moved into the workflow orchestration. For doing so, we used the HPC cluster that provides the set of tools that customers can use and customize to build HPC clusters on the IBM cloud. So it behaves as a regular cluster where you can use your LSF scheduler to set the number of worker nodes that you want, and your data, instead of being in a parallel file system, would be in an object storage. For this case, we run Oklahoma 10 meters, and this uses the virtual machines on the IBM cloud. But this HPC cluster also offers portable software solutions at runtime through container technologies such as Docker and Singularity. And we even observe some performance improvement with these portable software solutions. As a conclusion, we now can deploy SOMOS-5 with multiple and separate scenarios of data resolution on customized architectures on the HPC cluster and also portable platforms like Docker and Singularity. We define best practices to execute the workflow using the object storage and the solution of the LSF HPC cluster. Finally, as a future vision, we want to complete the composition of the SOMOS-5 in the cloud so it can be deployed on different systems and offer as a service to other scientists and users, such as precision agriculture, environment and science, and wildfire detection. Thank you so much for your attention, and please don't hesitate to ask any questions. Thank you again.